Okay, we're back at Wildcard. Sorry. We're back at Wildboard. The card. So I'm on my way to go see Larry Prosser. He's the father of three and the inventor of a card game, board game, the chess game, called Camelot 101.
You were alive and talking.
All right.
So all I wanted was, when did you start this? How many years ago?
Originally came up with the concept in 1996. And then it took me 2 years to build it. We used cardboard at first because it was just an idea to have play chess with my three sons. And so I just ripped up a couple of boards and put them beside each other. And we wore it out so much that I built one in wood. But it took 2 years to make it. And then I actually sold those. But it wasn't until recently that the technology has brought it about that I can make it, I can print a board, get pieces, get camo cards made and all that for a normal price, which is these more complex games are $80, and that's what I sell this for.
Okay, so this is your basic table, right? So now...
Correct. So this is the production. This is the production version because the, of course, the original is not easy to reproduce. And we broke it up into four levels so that people can start right away. So let me show you level one. And all you have to do is know how to play basic chess. You don't even have to be good at it. And I'll have you playing in 2 minutes. So you have four suits. You get five cards. Put the cards in the middle, that's considered one big square. And to show you how easy this game is, pick a card.
Just any random
card? Any card.
Okay.
Put it face up over here. So that's a heart. So hearts, diamonds, clubs, spades. So you gave me one. Ace is one single square. So I will move one single square. For your bravery of giving an opponent a move, you get another turn. This time you want to play a club, a spade, or a diamond. Your clubs, I'm hearts, these are neutral until one of us takes the king. You do have to call check, because there's so much going on, sometimes you don't even see it, and it's just an honorable game of Camelot saying, by the way, I got him in check with my bishop. That way I have one turn to save him, because if you take him, you get his king, 40 points, and you control both armies. Like Risk, it's world domination. So... your turn, you get a second turn because you gave
me... And I can move any character within these three.
Right.
So these two,
have a card.
These two are... Oh, okay.
Right.
So if I want to say, okay, so these guys, once again, are diamond, these are clubs, these are spades. So if I pull out a spade and I pull the king of spade...
So that's specifically the king.
Okay.
Queen, jacks are specific. Numbers are anything. So if you play the king of spades, you have two choices. You got to get him off the throne. So you make him a move.
Oh, but he can only go one of two ways anyway.
Right.
There.
Okay. We call this the royal throne because it's a little more protection than your one layer of defense in normal chess. So you always have five. Now the other thing about this game is you're learning the game. There's four levels. I've mastered the game, so therefore I am fate. I take the top card and play fate. We figure you need to beat fate to get to the tournament level. Because if you can beat fate, you're ready to go to the next level. If you can't beat fate, there's no way you're ever going to get
it. Have you written all these rules down?
Yes. They're all online, camelot101.ca.
Okay.
So everything's online, and all the different levels, and all the different rules, and I'll tell you about how they change every month. But right now, level one, I got a 10 of diamonds. So therefore, I'm going to move the neutral iron. Your turn.
Okay. Well, I don't have a lot to go on here. So if I give you the jack of hearts...
So I specifically have to move my knight.
Okay. Do you take the card?
You just put it there to show you.
And I take another card.
You take another one.
And I still get one extra move.
So you get club, diamond, or spade this time.
Club, diamond, or spade. Okay, so if I play a diamond, a random diamond, like a nine of diamonds.
You choose to play chess.
I can make the move.
Any player.
Any player. And I can move any move.
Sure.
Okay.
Right. Yours. Fate gives me one single spade. Your turn.
Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha. So I can play eight of spades.
And you decide.
And I can figure out what I can do. And he can go as far as I want him to go.
Up to eight.
Oh, up to eight. One,
your
two,
number
three,
is your
five.
Max.
Okay. And I can take this player as well with my own guy, can't
yep.
I? And
you
collect
could
the points
set him up
if I wanted.
In front of you if you want to make him vulnerable, but on the other hand, you could be tempting fate
use
because I could turn around and get a spade and take
oh,
it.
Oh, shit.
So now there's a risk factor in chess where never it used to be before. Because if you did a bad move, you got penalized. Now you could get away with it. You could be a bad chess player and still win at this game. This is where it makes it fun for new players because they're just learning the game and they might get away with it. Jokers are absolutely useless. They're bricks. So I lose a turn.
So it's a wasted space.
Yeah, you can refresh your hand.
That was supposed to be my card,
yep,
I think.
That's
so all right. Take it.
Take five. You can refresh your hand anytime. You don't like two, three, four of your cards or five of them, all five of them. Put them face down. It's called refreshing, and that's your turn. But
I
leave that as a last resort because you don't want to waste a turn. If you can move, move.
I have an awesome euchre hand, I'll tell you that much.
Okay.
But to go on again, what are the aces for? Just a single move,
one
correct?
Single square.
Okay, so that's just clubs. So this is clubs, that's spades, those are diamonds. Now,
right.
I only have diamonds and hearts. All so right. If I choose to move a diamond one spot.
One square.
But one square or
that
one
move? That takes
three. Yeah. Okay. That was my next question.
That's it. I'm going to give you the four because it's early. That way I get another turn.
So I have four moves that I can make here.
Yep.
So that counts as three. Can
that's
I still
it.
Go one? Or that's
one
it.
One chess
move.
One
okay.
Legal chess move up to four. I want to refresh. I'm turning the card face down. I don't want to play it. You can refresh up to five.
Oh, I know I can refresh. I can stick with this. So I can play my ten of clubs.
Yeah.
And I can move my guys.
Anybody.
Anybody. But only one move.
One legal chess move.
Okay.
Right. Yours?
Oh, yeah. I got to take a card. Got it.
I got the six of diamonds, and I will go here.
All I have are hearts and diamonds. Okay, I got a diamond. So I can play you, I can make a single
one
move.
One single square.
I can put him up there just so I can pancake
right.
Him later.
I will give you the six.
Okay, so I can make a move now?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to take this guy and collect some
right,
points.
That goes into your castle.
Okay.
You now have 3 points. If the timer were to go off right now, you would win.
Gotcha.
So, my second move, I'm going to refresh.
Okay. I'm going to give you a heart.
Right.
I
will call check. So, save the king.
But I don't have to save the king because I really don't care about him.
You do,
but then
because
you get the
he's
points.
40 points, and I would control both armies. And they can buy it here at Wildcard. They can also buy it at GG Games, Hobby Studio, Decode, and there's another Halo, Teddy and Me. Basically, check Camelot101.ca, and places are growing. And you can also just go on Facebook and catch it there. And I'll come, if you're in the GTA, I will come and meet you. Because I just want to, it's all about meeting people. I'm on Facebook, Camelot101 Facebook, and also Camelot101.ca if you want to see the rules. And but if you go to Facebook, you'll see all the tournaments, where they're being played, and the different places I visit. Contact me and challenge me anytime. I'd love to meet you and play you this fun game.
Okay, that's it. That's all I can add.
Okay, so that was Larry, and that was Camelot 101. I think you got all the directions you need from him about that. And if you have any questions, go to his Facebook group. Go to the Wildcard Board Game Cafe, because he is having a tournament coming up there on January 27th. And I think that'd be a lot of fun. I'd like to go check it out myself, because I am the chess master. Well, at least my kids think I am, but anyone older than 13, they're going to smoke me in that game. But yeah, if you like these kind of videos, leave a thumbs up.
And I do appreciate you stopping by and watching this, and hopefully we shall talk again. Thanks.